Fondue.
Oh yeah. You gotta get straight or it won't wind
No,
right,
you're
man.
almost done.
Good morning, everybody. Today is going to be a fantastic day. And also today at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time today, I mean, these videos go up at 5 Eastern when everybody's in school. During the summer, we'll go back to like a 9 a.m. upload schedule. But today at 7 p.m., so in a couple hours, if you're watching this right now, at 5 p.m. Eastern. But 7 p.m. Eastern, Africa videos will start coming out. It's going to be, what is it, Tuesday, Thursday, Sunday for the next like 2.5 weeks or so. We'll be posting some Africa videos for you guys. So I'm pretty excited about that. So today we got to get ready. We got Hector Rodriguez coming in town. I've got a bunch of mail. I mean, well, I've got a big box of mail there, but I have to go pick up more mail because Sarah left a key inside that box to a big giant box usually of mail. But we got Hector coming in on Wednesday, so I got to figure out, we're going fishing tomorrow, so we got a ton of stuff to get done today to get prepped for this week because it's going to be just nothing but fishing. Fishing. So I got to get everything done today. Got to get guns clean. Got to get the side-by-side put back in the garage and take you guys along for this, my daily journey, because I love taking you guys along. So, let's get started. So I got old Guns and Chicken Strips. He'll be linked below. I want you guys to go do me a favor and follow him, of course. But we've got him on hand because, well, a little while ago, he kind of...
We.
Nah, you were driving.
Yeah, but we.
This got bent, so he's got to lift this off. And we want to call in for the heavy hitters here. Because this trailer is not really the lightest thing on earth. But don't worry. I'm going to give it a little bit of oomph as well. Okay, so we've actually been, we've done a lot today. If you guys don't even, I didn't take you guys along for most of it because, well, it was a lot of driving, stopping for 2 or 3 minutes and then getting out. But this is what we got. We got, Jimmy built this, how long did you build this, Jimmy? 4 or 5 years ago?
About 5 years.
5 years ago. He built this stand. Now our goal is to, I went and picked these up. So we got these metal plates, which are going to be spray painted white with orange numbers on them. These are they're 3/4 inch steel. So they're for shooting. Now our goal is to make it, I wanted to get the most inexpensive way to hang them up, and Jimmy did this a couple years ago and I think it's going to hold just fine because those steel plates weigh 60 pounds a piece and we got 10 of them, so we need 10 stands. They're for pinging rounds real far, so we're going to put this together and see if it works. Oh, and I did go and pick up all that mail. I did do that. We got a whole bunch of extra mail that I will unbox here in a little bit. Got all my fishing poles I still got to get done, pick up the boat, get prepped for... Whew. Still got a bunch of stuff to do. Let's knock this out.
Boom.
Boom. Starting. I don't think it's going to rock that much, but that's pretty good. Now we just got to spray paint this bad boy real quick. Oh, this is nice, guys. This is really good. So basically, we spray painted with white. We spray painted the entire thing with white, and then we put orange numbers on. The reason why we use white is because you can see impact like crazy when a bullet hits something white like that. Oh, nice and white, Jimmy. There you go. You enjoying that?
Enjoying it. It's so smooth.
So here's what each one's end up going to look like. It's going to be labeled 1 through 10, painted white on this little base. I think we came up with a different idea how we're going to do this chain. We're still trying to feel like a quick release system. Me and Jimmy have kind of possibly got something figured out. We don't really know. We're going to tinker with it to get it done. Because you got to think about it. We got to go down, set them up, and then take them down each day. So it's got to be quick release. But we're going to get these done right now. We got these four. Another 5. So like I said, we got 10 steel targets. I'm pretty excited for this. You guys don't really understand. Let's knock them out. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Oh shit. I got all of them done. Got all 10 of them done. So you got five there, five stacked up here. I mean, that's 300 pounds of steel right there. They're freaking 60 pounds a piece. So we got that done. But I was originally gonna be posting this video, two videos in one day, and then I went and looked at the weather. I got my boat outside, I took the stuff off, and now I just put the cover back on the boat, and I'm just kind of pausing on rigging my rods, but I'm gonna be going smallmouth fishing the next day. It is going to be horribly storming tomorrow. It's gonna be 30 plus mile an hour winds and raining all day. Now, there's one thing I know that camera equipment doesn't do well with is rain and cold. I can deal with rain, you know, I got stuff, but 30 plus mile an hour winds on a lake is very dangerous. You get rollers, it's not too smart. So if I don't have to go out and fish in those kind of conditions, I'm not going to. Now, if it was a different situation where I had to figure out what was going on that day, say a tournament or something like that, I would go out and do it. But for this case, well, I guess while you guys are watching this video, I'm probably actually fishing, but there's a reason why I didn't post. I think I started off the video, I was like, oh yeah, there's a video going up at 7. Well, it was posted yesterday. The Africa video was posted yesterday now because this video is now up on Wednesday. But you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna figure out what's inside this mail. Look at this freaking gun. Holy crap. This is Jim's. This is Jimmy's. The guys you guys saw earlier, the Guns and Chickens. This is his 500 Smith & Wesson Magnum. Freaking sick. So anyway, if you guys want to see this thing shot, go check out his channel. I don't even think I've mentioned any of this. This thing is freaking boom, basically a handheld elephant gun right there. Anyway, I'll link this channel below if you guys want to go check it out. But you know what we got to do now? We've got some mail to go through. So we got some mail to go through. I mean, we got this giant box right here. This is going to be the first one I'm going to start with. This is from Eddie Olson in Indiana. Okay, real quick. So everybody keeps asking. He even says it right here. Hope he likes, really enjoys the Military Monday is coming back. Actually, next weekend, I am flying to Pittsburgh to interview a veteran that I actually have never met in my entire life. He told me he's got a story he wants to tell. So I am flying up there on my own dime. Actually, you know what's funny about that is all those Never Fear Anything and all this apparel, that really helps me actually go and do this. That's why I'm like so adamant on trying to sell these hats and or t-shirts, which are always linked below. That's what helps me pay for these trips because they're very expensive. All right, so anyway, this is from Eddie. Thank you, Eddie, so much. Let's take a look at what he's got for right off the bat. I'm going to say I absolutely love the koozies. Who doesn't want... Oh, that's the wrong one. Who doesn't want a Guggen Squad koozie or a Lunkers TV koozie? I think that's freaking awesome. Thank you so much. Which is funny because my apparel guy was just asking me if I want koozies. Does anybody want koozies? This guy just brought it up. You sent me one. Thank you so much. And like I said, all those apparel sales helps me travel to tell the story for the veterans, which I really hope this guy... He told me he's got some really badass stories, so hopefully it's... And he's got videos and pictures. It's gonna be sick. All right, here we go. The giant... Something, I don't know yet. It's wood. Lunkers TV edition. What the hell? This is so cool. Look at this. AKA, oh my. Dude, you spent some time on this. This is freaking awesome. I love the Fisherman's Flare or Prayer says Flares, AKA Flares. This is so awesome, man. Thank you so much. This is so awesome. Thank you. So I'm going to do something real quick. I got a message. My wife has been sending me this stuff. These from people that are mainly actually all of them. They're from girls asking for their Valentine's Day. I don't know. So anyway, this is, I just did one the other day. Took a picture in front of my boat with holding some sign. Anyway, this right here is from Melissa. Make sure I don't mess it up. Melissa Polson. Okay. Melissa Polson, if you're watching, I've got your message. And she wanted me to say, what's up to Peter Figueroa? For her, this is like her Valentine's Day gift to him is me. And I don't really know if a lot of people like watching these unboxing videos, but yeah, I like doing them. It gives me a direct connection with everybody that sends me this stuff. You know what I mean? I feel like me and everybody else that watches this channel, I feel like that we kind of have like me and you that I'm talking to you right now as you're watching me. I feel like we have like some sort of connection because you watch me either every single day or you might be new to this channel. But we have a connection either or, you know what I mean? Oh, this is Two Guns and Chicken Strips too. Cool. So anyway, yeah, that's why I like doing these. And there's a lot of them that are like bigger ones this time. Like, I wonder how big this one is. Sorry. This one. Oh, I gotta finish what I'm doing. I'm all over the place. You know, I was just talking about a second ago, like being like able to connect with you guys. And this is one of the ways I can do it. Like, say right here, we have Kyle Harper. Kyle Harper sent me this. He sent me a letter. Of course, I read it. And he sent me this. And he wants me to sign it. That's another thing. If you guys want me to do that, I don't mind doing it. I actually think it's amazing because it's like another way for me to actually connect. And if I may never be able to meet you in real life, this is like one way. I'm going to sign this thing, send it off to him. And now he has something that I personally sent to him. So we made more of a connection. So anyway, I just want to say thank you to Kyle. And everybody else that sends stuff like this right here, what we got? Chase Miller wants me to put in the video, so I'm going to. So I gotta go to Sharpie. Oh, but I do say if you guys want me to sign something, and please put a return envelope with a stamp and write your stuff on it. I'll sign it, shove it in the mail, and it's good to go. Sarah actually helps me out a lot with that, by the way. Also, I'm just gonna throw this out there. I'm sitting here looking at this live subscriber count. And we're at 299,964. We are 36 away from 300K. You know how crazy that is? Because a year ago, what month are we in? February 13th last year, I think I may have had 500 to 1,000 subs max. So in like a year, I've gained 300,000 subs, which is so crazy. See what can change in a year. Your life could absolutely change in a year. And just never, like, I can go over, like, man, so many times. I used to post my stuff on this website called, like, the Texas Fishing Forum. Now, everybody on that website absolutely despises me because I was, like, a younger guy making videos, having a good time. And for some reason, those older guys, they absolutely hated it. Now, if I would have listened to any one of them talking about, you need to quit doing this, you're bad for the fishing industry, you're just complete shit is what they were saying, I wouldn't be here right now. So I guess the moral of the story is, thank you so much for getting me to 300,000 subscribers. I'm hoping maybe by the end of the video, we'll be able to say, holy shit, we're at 300K. That's what I'm hoping, at least. And just don't let anybody get in your way. That's another good thing. I mean, I just feel like I'm more of a John B. sentimental type piece, but don't let anybody get inside of your way from accomplishing something that you want to do. Like my aunt always told me, you can do anything you set your mind to, and I absolutely believe it 100%. Well, I wouldn't tell you guys that. I need to get back done doing this mail. I'm sorry. That was just me checking on my sub count because I knew I was getting close, and I thought you know what? Gotta give you guys a little bit of motivation if you're going through a tough time. So I just received a bag of TJ Russell, thank you so much, dude. You sent me a ton of these rattles. I don't know if you guys have watched me use these. I talk about them. They're really hard to get, or they were hard for me to get. And now it just seems like every single time I said something was really hard to get, you guys send them. You sent like, dude, you sent me a ton of great stuff. Thank you so much. It's so cool. So awesome. Thank you. Look at this. Boom. We got to it. I just had to flip the computer on and then let it sit there and just roll. 300,000 subscribers. That's so crazy. Thank you so much. Thank you, Emerson, for sending me this. This is literally like a Lunkers TV package on the go. White spinnerbait, 10-pound frog, or the frog that caught the 10-pounder. You had the crankbait, the brush hogs, the Senkos, the trick worms. Even more Senkos that I poured out of the bag a second ago. This, you sent me a little, hopefully you didn't send me all your tackle. Okay, we're gonna go on this last one. This is from Eric. Eric sent me these. He found these at the yard sale. I mean, this one's, I don't know why. This is kind of cool. Product of Lunker City. I'm gonna hang it up right there because I don't know why. That's just cool. It has, I don't know how old it is. Now I'm kind of interested in how old these baits are. But he found them at the garage sale. Anyway, yeah, wow. We've got a lot of stuff that came in the mail today. This is just amazing. I really do appreciate everything that you guys do from watching this channel, supporting it, sending me cool stuff like you guys did today. and sticking through these videos when there's 30 mile an hour winds and torrential pouring rain. Hope you guys enjoy this video. If you haven't checked out the Africa videos, they will be linked below. Make sure to go check those out, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Thank you for everything. Thanks for 300,000. And as always, you know what? I'll see you guys. I know the book.